Things. Here again we have one of the easiest questions from Jet Transform, asked in GATE EC 2009 for 1 mark. You see, the reason of convergence of Jet Transform of the discrete time sequence x of n is 1 by 3 power n u of n minus 1 by 2 power n u minus n minus 1 is. So in no time we can go for the option, right? See, from this we can say option A is correct. So 1 mark, it took approximately 1 second to go for the correct option. Why? See, because here what we have, this is a causal sequence. As it is a causal sequence, ROC is exterior. Okay, ROC is exterior and this 1 by 3 is pole. Okay, so ROC is, this modulus of Z is greater than 1 by 3. And this one is anti-causal sequence, right? So ROC is always interior for anti-causal sequence. That means mod Z is less than 1 by 2. Interior means less than, exterior means greater than. So modulus of Z is greater than 1 by 3 means, what is 1 by 3 less than modulus of Z? Okay. And obviously we have this modulus of Z less than half. So you put it down here. So therefore option A is correct. Approximately 1 second to decide the correct answer, right? So this is what you have in this case. If you want to go for its details, let me go in this way. For example, say I have a signal x of n. So x of n Z transform is say x of z. Okay, now let me take x of n is equal to some a power n u of n. If I take x of n equal to a power n u of n, its z transform is what? 1 over 1 minus a z power minus 1. Or simply we can make it like this, z over z minus a, both are same. Okay, so this fellow will converge. So this compact form will converge whenever this az power minus 1, if I make this az power minus 1, if it is less than 1. Okay, so therefore we can also make it this way, we can also make it mod z kind of stuff here. So from this we could say, if I take modulus of z, this must be greater than modulus of a. So whenever you have causal sequence, ROC is always exterior. So if you take this a complex plane, that is Z plane, say you have a pole at Z equal to A. So you take a pole at Z equal to A. Okay, this is at Z equal to A, you have a pole. So ROC is greater than this. So ROC is greater than this, this A. So this ROC is defined here and ROC is not defined in the internal zone. Alright. So therefore in place of A we have 1 by 3, right? So therefore you just go for it like this, mod Z greater than 1 by 3. So that is what this one. And whenever you have anti-causal sequences, see, if you want to plot this sequence, this 1 by 3 power n u of n, it is as follows. You can plot it down like this. This is n. This is just we want to plot 1 by 3 power n, say u of n. Okay, at n equal to 0, it is 1. 1 by 3 power 0 is 1, u of 0 is also equal to 1. At n equal to 1, it is 1 by 3. At n equal to 2, this is 1 by 9. So on. So you would get a causal sequence like this. So the journey of this causal sequence is going all the way, like this, so on. Yeah, until infinity it goes on like this. So like this. Okay, so anyways we have this sequence and its corresponding ROC is this is real part of Z and this is imaginary part of Z, and whatever you have a Z plane where Z is a complex variable, so therefore this is a complex plane. Now if you take anti-causal sequence, now what I have anti-causal sequence like this, minus a power n. See, this minus is outside the bracket, not inside. So minus a power n u minus n minus 1. If you take its z transform, again we get same thing, 1 over 1 minus a multiplied by z power minus 1. Okay, but then what is the difference here? For causal sequence a power n u of n, we got this compact form, and for anti-causal sequence also we obtain the same compact form. Then if I take its inverse, then which one do I get? Do I get this anti-causal sequence or this causal sequence? Yeah, so uniqueness of this transformation or uniqueness of your signal can be determined not only with this closed compact form, this Z transform, but also with ROC, right? So this ROC will make your stuff unique always. So ROC in this case is what? Mod Z is less than A. So whenever you have anti-causal sequence, ROC is always interior. So now in place of A, what do you have? In place of A, we have half in the question. So U minus N minus 1. So therefore, if you take its Z transform, you will get 1 over 1 minus half Z power minus 1. But in this case, ROC is mod Z is not greater than half. This is less than half. So therefore, if you want to draw this, so if you want to show it, so if you want to show this, so this is my real quantity, real Z, and here we have imaginary, here we have imaginary Z. Now here what do you have? This Z is greater than 1 by 3, and here we got Z less than half. So 1 by 2 is greater than 1 by 3. So let me take some 1 by 3 pole. That means you have a pole whose value is say 1 by 3. So let me draw a circle. Okay, let me draw a circle like this. And say this is half. Okay, this is half. So let me draw one more circle passing through this. One more circle passing like this. Okay, so now we have this option, right? Mod Z greater than 1 by 3. So this ROC is this mod Z greater than 1 by 3. You have to go like this. Okay, this is what mod Z greater than 1 by 3. And then also we have mod Z less than half. So mod Z less than half is like this. Okay, so this is mod Z less than half. Now the overlapping region is what? This is the overlapping region. Yeah, so this is angular region, annular or intersection region or overlapping region. So this part is your ROC. So this one is your ROC. Okay, so the very first option is the correct one. Thank you.